You don't have a car. How does that work?
People ask me about why and how I catch buses and get places. And the only thing that you need is time. Because to get from, say, downtown San Diego to Escondido allows 3.5 hours. There's just depending on the time of day, you can really spend time. But the good thing about that is that on the bus, you meet all sorts of people. And they have all sorts of opinions and ideas about food and tell you if you're going to Escondido, well, you've got to go to the Greasy Spoon on 4th and C. And so you really kind of get a feel. And the other great thing is that you can, you're kind of, I call it my stretch limo because it is a limo well stretched and there's somebody driving for you. So you can ride all the way up and ride all the way back. Or sleep all the way up and sleep all the way back. And so I've grown to love it. And actually there's like the rural buses that go from El Cajon to points east, like Jamul and towards El Centro. They are just so full of characters. And they are kind of take it easy and they'll let you off and people can have a sort of pee stop if they need to. And it's far less official than you kind of think if you're just catching a downtown bus. So I've grown to love it. Last night I was on the a bus coming home and it was crammed with baseball fans going to the stadium. And it was a standing room only, and suddenly at 12th and Imperial, everybody got off. And getting on was this old guy who was had two huge black plastic bags and a little trolley, so his entire life was with him, and his smell was kind of, so I'm ashamed to say that I went up to the back just to be away from the smell, and lo and behold, he comes up the back and sits right beside me on the back seat. So we get into conversation, and it turns out that he was a jazz singer from New Orleans. Who had sung songs, I can't remember them now, but he told me all about that, and he told me all about Cajun cooking and how you really make a good roux and the three magic items that you've got to have in every new. So what a conversation. And at the end, I felt bad about him, you know, because he obviously was not. So I said, well, would you like a couple of dollars and would that help you out? And he said, no, but 20 would be good.
Have you ever been caught either because you took the trolley or the bus where they shut down for the evening?
Yes, I have. I've had a few of those. One was Escondido where I missed the last bus. And there I was incredibly lucky because just happening by was somebody I had actually met, and there's a restaurant not there but in Oceanside, which where they have these chapulines, so-called, which are the grasshoppers. They're mixed tech cooking, and so he and I had happened to be the only people eating these chapulines, and so we started a conversation in the restaurant, and he went by and sort of said, "Do you need a lift?" And this was about 11:30 at night, and he took me all the way down to La Jolla, where I could connect with another bus that was still running. I don't think of myself as a food critic because I'm not good at sort of saying, well, there's not enough paprika here, and there should be more salt in the chops or whatever. And I'm a fairly, I pretty much like anything unless it's really bad or unless it gives me stomach cramps. And
how often does that happen?
It's very rare. In fact, I can only remember one time, and that was from a fairly up-end, I won't name it, but it was a fairly up-end, higher-end restaurant which had a happy hour. And it was a kind of pate thing. The only thing is that I go by is if there's people there and other people are risking their lives, you know, then you've got a pretty good bet. As long as there's other people tracking, or even when they're not, you know, if it looks like a going concern. And I've learned so much from just pushing myself to sort of try different things different ethnic things and different takes on the greasy spoon idea, and pretty much it's all good, and you don't have to overdo it and sort of try everything. You can get a pretty good idea from just ordering one dish.
Have you ever been to a healthy restaurant?
Oh yes. Cilantro in Chula Vista, R.I.P. It was raw. It was all about raw food, and the whole idea there was this lovely lady. She was from Mexico City, I think. But her whole idea, which I think is scientifically true, that enzymes, if you heat them up to beyond 110 degrees, it kills the enzymes, and the enzymes are the things that you need to translate food into your body. And so she did everything raw. And so you had everything from mud pies to sort of steaks to shepherd's pie and that sort of thing, all done, but only kind of heated to 109 degrees. And so it was all warm, but not hot. And I came out there feeling incredibly healthy. The best breakfast that I can remember, and of course, you know, you start sort of losing about 10 back, you start losing, but the best one I've had recently is Mariscos Herman. It's down on Palm Avenue in IB, just east of IB. They do breakfast burritos there, the most huge breakfast burritos that you can imagine, and they always have a special where you get a Budweiser, can of Budweiser, with the breakfast, and you can do it for about $2.50. It's unbelievable.
Did you say $2.50?
$2.50, yeah. So that's a special. I mean, if you're going to have the Siete Mares or anything like that, then you'll be up in the $9 bracket. But this is that they have deals, and it's half of the thing of satisfaction having a good meal is the fact that you know you're only paying $2.50, so it tastes better. Place with the best view would certainly be the Mount Signal Cafe, and that is in the desert just west of El Centro, and which you can see. It's like a sort of cowboy shack, and the lady who has always run it, and I haven't been there for a couple of years, but she is a lady bullfighter. And the place is just, she's had bullfighters, famous bullfighters, come there, and their signatures and bull horns are everywhere, and she will tell you tales of how hard it is to be a lady bullfighter in Mexico. But you go out into the veranda, and at sunset, where you sit there and you look to all the mountains between the Antarctica Desert and San Diego, and on the other side, the Chocolate Mountains, and the sun setting there across the desert is unbelievable. And the other unbelievable thing is the silence. I mean, you can hear your heart breathe as you eat your meal, and pretty good meals too, by the way. You know, how many hamburgers and eggs can you have and give a different description? So I'm always interested in the people just as much, or maybe even more than the food. So I always get to talking with them afterwards, just to find out their family saga and how they came to be there. So by the time I finished, I usually know them pretty well. And a couple of times I've had to say, well, could I come back with the rest of the money? Because I discovered that I'm a little skint right now. I didn't realize how much I ate. And in fact, this does happen before I get talking, because I have to pay for it before I get talking. You know, usually we're friends enough by then, and they, without exception, they haven't sort of, you know, done that classic thing of, get out of here, you bum, never come back, and splat on the sidewalk. They are usually, you know, that's all right. We know you look an honest kind of guy, and just come back and pay me later. And I pretty much always have, as far as I can remember.
One last question. Now, I know it's been a number of years since you've performed on stage, but do you not still get dogged all the time by autograph hounds and photograph takers?
They hear my voice, they know who I've got to be, that I must have fallen on hard times. And so, yes, I'm signing it all the time. They just ask me to say one thing every time. Just say, thank you very much.
Love me tender, love me sweet, never let me go. You have made my life complete, and I love you so. Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I always will. Love me tender, love me long, take me to your heart. For it's there that I belong, and will never part. Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill.